What is your level of humility? Today I wanted to discuss three different pillars which I believe you could apply something today to make yourself a little bit happier in your everyday life. Hey everyone, welcome to Max's Journal. Today, as I mentioned, I wanted to discuss three different pillars that I believe you could apply a little bit of humility in realizing a few things that you can apply today to get you a little bit happier. So the first one is health. Health, to my belief, is something that's very much within yourself. It's a bit of a, what you would call, discipline. You know, like the free Maccas, McDonald's, but or the ice cream or the chocolate or anything that you know is not deserved or not good for you. Because there's nothing wrong with a bit of junk food. There's always a good way to reward yourself after a hard week or a hard month or a hard year of solid, good nutritional, good food. And that's, I believe, something that can very easily be applied to you for anyone that's trying to get a little bit healthier and feel better about themselves visually. That is the one thing that you can apply. It really comes down to your level of humility. You know, like, how humble can you be to say, Max, you've been terrible this week. Time for you to, you know, step it up a bit. So that's one of the pillar. The second one is, and something that I believe a lot of you that are following on this video, I have been watching or looks at a lot, which is wealth. Wealth is obviously a very broad subject, and it's something that is not easy for everyone. Not everyone is fortunate enough to have a bit of wealth or understanding what money is, because that really comes down to education, and that's a whole different topic. But wealth is anything that you can do today, you know, save on that extra dollar, that thing that you don't want to buy, you know, buying things, buying, just accumulating, excuse my language, but stuff that you do not need or you believe you need for a quick little fix, but that does not actually help you in your everyday life, or not in your everyday life, maybe in your everyday life, but in your overall life. So what is that little thing that you can learn or not buy that will make you a bit wealthier, but also more aware of your wealth pillar and get you to a better stage? A stage that you know deep inside you are seeking, something that you know in the big picture is what you really, truly, genuinely want. Lastly is health, wealth, love. The last one is love. Love is, now that's a very sort of personal sort of approach to everything. If you don't have a partner, is it about taking the first step to reaching out to that person that you've been thinking about, you know, texting them, calling them? Or if it's someone that you already have in your life, like your partner, doing something for them, you know, because by pleasing others, you please yourself. You know, that's it's a very common fact that you can probably generate, you can probably have and feel more happiness by giving someone else some happiness. And that's, you know, when you look at your kids' eyes, whenever they discover something for the first time, you're just used to it. But for them, it's the first time, and you can see the joy, and you get some joy out of that. So if it's to do something about your kid, go out there and do something special for your kids. But don't ruin pillar two. Don't go and buy something he or she doesn't deserve. Don't jeopardize one pillar to get to the other one. Remember, like, you just gotta be humble, your level of humility to understand and really take a step back and see what are those few things you can apply to any of these three pillars. So don't be too hard on yourself, maybe apply one at a time, but yeah, just go out there and, you know, just do something that you believe will fulfill you a bit more, because it really comes down, happiness is really all about a momentum. And the moment you do something great, you want to do something even greater. And it's like anything else you do in life, you know, like I've mentioned in the previous video, you start cleaning the kitchen sink, 2 hours later you find yourself cleaning the bathroom floor, because momentum, action creates reaction. So yeah, that's what I wanted to talk to you about today. I hope that you go out there and make someone happier, or you make yourself feel a bit better, because remember, you have one life, you can't replenish time, it's money comes and goes, but your time doesn't come back. So make the most of it. Thank you very much for watching. Remember, stay happy, stay fulfilled, and I will see you next time in Max's Journal. Bye for now.